Hello, it's Mad Science Channel, and today we will find out what will happen if you leave a large fish on a large anthill in the forest. I think this experiment will be interesting to you. After all, I have always wondered what will happen in this case. In order to shoot such a release, we went several hundred kilometers from the big city, where a large dark forest was already waiting for us. We went there in search of an anthill. We found the anthill in about an hour. The owners of this anthill were red forest ants. Such ants live mainly in coniferous forests. The body length of such an ant varies from 7 to 14 millimeters. As soon as I put this fish on the anthill, ants began to protect it in every possible way. Sure thing. After all, even flies flew to such an overseas dish. Ants often took trading positions, lifting the bottom of their abdomen. If we talk about the venom of these forest ants, then it consists of about 50% formic acid. Red forest ants are included in the red list of threats to other species from the International Red List of the World Conservation Union. Lists of rare animals are also included in some regional red data book. Of the main questions, what are these ants in the forest for? Red forest ants play an important role of the regulation of the number of forest pets. First of all, leaf-eating caterpillars, butterflies and sawfly caterpillars. Also, ants improve the soil and settle the seeds of forest plants. For example, one large anthill saves a quarter of a hectare of wooded area from pests. That is why I decided to feed this whole ant brotherhood with such a big fish. Well, the most interesting thing is to leave this fish for 24 hours in an anthill and then come back and see what happens there. I am more than sure that the ants liked the fish. For you, of course, it was a couple of seconds. But 24 hours have already passed and it's time to return to the anthill. By the way, press pause now and write, what do you think happened to this fish? I offer three options. The first option is that the ants ate it and only bones remain. The second option, it was eaten by the one who left these traces. Well, the third option, the fish is untouched. Ready? Now it's time to see what happened. As you can see, everything is fair. We even overexposed for 30 minutes, but there was no fish on the anthill. Moreover, this anthill didn't even have any traces that there had ever been a fish. At some certain point, it seemed to me that the anthill became a little higher, and it seemed to me that the ants covered this fish with soil. I unrolled the anthill quite a bit to see if it was really so. But the fish were not there. For me, this truly became the biggest mystery. Where could the fish have disappeared? And could some forest dwellers pull this fish from the anthill and not be afraid of the bites of these ants? After all, they protect their homes quite well. I just noticed how some beetle got into this anthill. In just seconds, a whole army of these ants attacked this intruder. This time I did not interfere, since this is a forest process that should be take place naturally. Well, as for the forest thief who stole the fish, I offer you such an interesting option. If this video gets 10,000 likes, I will definitely buy some photo traps that can take videos and photos even at night. I will place them there in different angles for 24 hours and leave them with different delicious food. And then I think we will definitely find out who could steal this food there. If you want such a release, write "I want" in the comments and do not forget to put likes if you expect such a release. But thanks to the large number of likes, I will see that you need it. As for this beetle, in such a short time it became immobilized. But since dads have lost their fish, they would have such an unusual beetle for dinner. Subscribe to the channel if you have not done it yet. And be sure to press the bell so as not to miss new episodes.